morning, and welcome to The Lifeline, where we are catching God's pulse. It's great to worship with you today. The service is designed to equip and inspire adults to live life the way their Heavenly Father designed it to be lived. So no matter what season of life you're in or where you are in your spiritual journey, you're welcome here. Let's begin by introducing our worship leaders. Delivering today's message is Ben Lewis. Leading our worship service today is Ken Soltes. Please keep Ken in your prayers over the coming weeks as he travels to Kenya to teach leaders in the areas of kingdom dynamics, identity in Christ, hearing the voice of God, and more. He'll be conducting rallies for the public and demonstrating the new song. While Ken is away, please pray for his protection and divine guidance. Ken, our prayers and best wishes go with you. Parents with children, this is family-centered worship, so your kids will stay with you for the duration of the service. If you did not come with a satchel full of goodies to keep your children occupied, feel free to grab an activity bag located by the back doors of the MAC. Parents with babies, a nursery is available for infants through kindergartners. It's in the first two doors on the left in the children's wing of the church. Following this service, we invite everyone to find the Sunday school class that's right for you. The youth are downstairs, the children are down the hall to the old fellowship hall, and most adult classes are held in this end of the building. For more information about adult Sunday school classes, please see a member of our Radical Hospitality team or grab a brochure at the desk. Wednesdays are very busy days here at the church. Our fundamentals program is open to all kids, grades 1 through 6, starting at 3:30. The kids knock out their homework, then have an afternoon of, well, being kids. Then at 5 o'clock, we have our Wednesday night dinner. Following dinner, we offer Bible study programs for all ages. The Methodist Youth Fellowship meets every Sunday evening. It includes dinner and an activity. You can find out all the details by liking us on Facebook. Over the next 7 weeks, Ben will be looking into the book of John and taking a deep dive into the questions that God asks us. So Ben will be spending some time today in the book of John. In John 1, verses 35 through 42, we see that John the Baptist has just recognized and testified that Jesus is the Son of God. The next day, John and two of his disciples see Jesus walk by. John says, "Look, the Lamb of God." When the disciples heard this, they followed Jesus. Jesus saw them following. He stopped, turned around, and said, "What are you looking for?" I'm sure this must have been a very intense moment for the disciples. I mean, that's a pretty loaded question. What are you looking for? But they answered with a question of their own. Where are you staying? Rather than telling them where he was staying, Jesus said, "Come and see." It's like he was saying, "You'll see what you're looking for. You'll find what you're seeking." We can be certain that it was exactly what they were looking for. So what are we looking for as we follow Christ? The first disciples were living in expectation of a Messiah, someone anointed and sent by God to save the people. They were looking for a Savior. They began following Jesus and kept following because, presumably, they found the Savior that they sought in Jesus. When we hear that word, Savior, many of us think automatically of what we learned in Sunday school, that Jesus saves us from our sins. We might assume that the Jesus died for our sins lesson is the only real way to talk about a Savior. But the what are you looking for question that Jesus asked really makes us think about this whole concept of Savior. What do you need saving from? Maybe you're looking for a Savior in the Sunday school sense of it. You may be struggling with sin and you feel powerless to it. You may be addicted to drugs or alcohol or even to unhealthy food. Maybe you're in a relationship with someone other than your spouse. Or maybe you're involved in dishonest business practices. You may have come to hate yourself for the ways that you have failed, and that self-loathing just seems to push you deeper and deeper into the behavior that you hate. If what you're looking for is a Savior from your sin, you have found what you're looking for in Christ. Jesus revealed to us God's will to forgive not just once, not just 70 times, but 7 times, 70 times for the same offense. God's will to forgive is inexhaustible. Christ can free us where human programs fail us. If a Savior from sin is what you're looking for, follow Jesus. If what you're looking for is a Savior from your wounds, you've found what you're looking for. The world is full of the walking wounded. Other people can leave us bruised and bleeding, sometimes literally, but more often figuratively. We can experience so much cruelty and heartlessness in people that we want to trust, and this can leave us emotionally beat up. We may look well and whole on the outside, but feel downright destroyed on the inside. So if you're looking for a healer, you've found what you're looking for. Jesus brought great healing during his earthly ministry, both emotional and physical. Since that day, deeply wounded people have found healing in the love of Jesus. Many will testify that Christ has miraculously healed them of physical illness, but not everyone who seeks physical healing will be cured. But this we know, healing can happen even when curing does not. Love heals. Christ heals. Christ gives us the capacity to rise above our losses and go on living. If what you're looking for is a Savior to heal your pain, follow Jesus. If what you're looking for is a Savior from a meaningless life, Jesus is the one you seek. Our days here on earth are precious and few. It's so tragic when people go through life focused only on their own pleasure or their own pain. Many of us have a very deep need to connect to something bigger than ourselves, to feel that we have a role in God's work in this world. If what you're looking for is a savior from a futile and hollow existence, follow Jesus. I believe that Christ is enough for us, for our deepest needs, but God does not give us in Christ everything that we want. If we're looking for comfort and ease all of our days, that's not Jesus. If we're looking for someone to protect us from every loss and every sorrow, that's not Jesus. If we're looking for someone to give the holy stamp of approval to all of our opinions, that's not Jesus. And if we're looking for someone to confirm our prejudices concerning who God hates, that's not Jesus. But if you're looking for a Messiah, a Savior, a teacher, a companion, someone to stir you up higher and deeper into the life of the Spirit, that is Jesus. Follow him. What are you looking for? Know Christ and make Christ known. Welcome to Lifeline.